How's it going, guys? Today we are back with another video. We're doing something a little different this time. We recently got our hands on a new iPhone 12 Pro Max, and this thing is incredible. One thing we wanted to check out though is we wanted to see how far the camera has come. So we've decided to compare it today to a high-end Canon DSLR and see just how big the gap is. We've got a few scenarios. We've got a nifty 50 for portraits, we've got a telephoto for zoom, and we've got a high-end video lens, a 24-105, that we'll be trying out some action shots with. So stay tuned, and it should be a good one. I wish that I would have known I was on your mind. I wish that I... So we are going to try the telephoto out first. We've come to Tafelberg Road in Cape Town, and we've got fantastic views of the city. So let's see how this compares. I was on your mind. We are going to be doing an action shot test for, I guess, speed. I don't know, this is just fun for us. We've got Richard, who's brought his longboard, and we're gonna test what it's gonna be like for the cameras. Something interesting, this road is blocked off as an actual road, but you can still walk it. But this used to be a road that went all the way along Table Mountain. Super cool. It's a bit dilapidated now, but it's fine, it's cool. You can still walk here for now.
Yeah, it is pretty windy, eh?
So here I am doing a voiceover because the wind got so bad that the audio was unusable. Pretty much what we are explaining is that Richard is going to skate down the hill and we are going to take action photos of him as he comes past and see how good the photos come out.
Be careful, Richie.
Safety first,
then see what. Amen. So thanks to iOS 14, we no longer have access to burst mode on iPhone, although this has a high shutter speed for sport mode. I can do, I think it's eight shots a second. That is limited to like two. That's very interesting. This phone's actually performing quite a bit better than I expected. Wow. Getting pretty windy up here. As we know, it's always windy in Cape Town, but it's really bad today, especially for audio. So sorry for you guys listening to this. So I think we're gonna go down here. There's a really nice kind of sheltered area with trees and hopefully no wind. So yeah, we'll see how it goes. Hello. So we've arrived. I'm shooting with the 50mm already, as you can tell. It's a little bit better, I would say. Not by much though, not by much. So we were struggling to figure out what we were going to do portraits with, but I think we found our new model, eh? Look at that good boy. Kicking in relatively soon, and we are pretty far away from home. We are probably going to head back outside, and then we will get to a nice spot for the night shots. Okay, so bonus round. It's getting a bit dark outside, so we decided to try out some low light stuff. We've got a lovely view out here, and yeah, we'll see how it does. Did you think were best? Personally, I think the DSLR still has the edge just in terms of control, but the fact that phones have come this far, it actually amazes me. What do you think? So in South Africa, the iPhone costs 35,000 rand, which is more or less what a full-frame DSLR costs. Do you think it's worth the money? Obviously, you get a lot more features with that, but would you buy that? And yeah, let us know. As always, please like, subscribe, comment, and please share this video. It really helps us out. And thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.